Good morning. I'm on my way to beautiful Burbank right now. My car is still a fucking mess. I haven't made the time to make that car wash happen just yet. I spent all day yesterday editing that long ass video for you and the Q&A along with that video. So today I have some tattoos to make. I'm not sure what I'm quite doing. I have some notes in my calendar, but I don't see any reason to give it all away. I figure we'll figure it out all together. And I think that I want to make a theme with today's vlog thing of how to set an appointment and how that kind of goes. So I kind of want to show some dialogue between me and my clients and how they approached me and how I replied back, and show them picking their design and how we decide and how it all goes down. I think that there's a misconception that people just only pick off the wall of the line book and they get what they get, but it's a lot more complicated than just that. And today's video hopefully will explain a little bit about that. I definitely do custom stuff all the fucking time. People don't really know what that entails, so hopefully today's video gives you some details. Next clip, we'll be walking into my little tiny baby studio in Burbank. See you then.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
You good yourself?
Not bad. Let me get you in this little fortified hidden studio. There's different keys for every door. Not my choice, but my problem to bear, I think it's this one right here.
Yeah, this one's similar. Yeah, this one doesn't have the star, but it's really similar to that dagger as well. I try to keep the dagger kind of simple, like, you know, when you're talking about this idea, you want like rose and dagger, so I don't want like a big distracting dagger and then a rose, you know what I mean? So yeah, I want to see the rose, then the dagger. I like how this one has like the stem kind of wrapping around, it's a little bit different. This one's kind of funky, but I think it's kind of cool because it's kind of funky. Mm-hmm. Which arm did you want to put it on? Yeah, you have a big arm, so we can do, I could print some out, could hold some stuff to your arm. You might be better off possibly, you already shaved up, that's so sick. You might be better off doing like something here maybe. Let's see, because it's kind of a wide arm, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's kind of a wide arm. I think if you did a dagger, I would say do one that's more busy because this one's pretty narrow. I would say do something more like with a bigger body so it fills up that arm, because then you're gonna be in the situation like, you know, what do I put around it later on? And you wanna have the tattoo then fill, or not have your tattoo and put a bunch of crap around it and now you're not looking at the actual rose and dagger that you got today, you know? These are a bit small, but you can hold those up to your arm, get an idea. It's actually not a bad size, but you see what I mean by like a bigger body rose would fill your bigger form a bit better. I will let that dry, then I'm gonna go ahead and draw some things on it, you know, make it fit really good. All right, so I'm just gonna doodle some stuff on here and then get your approval for the go ahead. See, people ask like, do you make custom tats or is it just out of line book? You're getting a custom tat right now, dude.
Sweet.
Tailor fitted to each person, you know what I mean? That already looks better. That does a lot for it right off the bat. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's super cool. But then I think I'm gonna do, I don't know if I wanna add one on that side. I like how it's just on that side, that looks nice. I mean, I could do like some little thing like that, or maybe a couple little, these are kind of fun. Sounds loud and scary, then it's working for me, you know what I mean? Gotta strike a little fear into your heart. Make sure you really want it. Make sure you're really a bad boy for life.
You know what, keep those $40, I'm out.
I'm gonna start off the bottom, kind of work my way up. It should suck down here, it should suck up here, but in the middle it should be a pretty easy area. Ready?
Ready.
Alright, here we go. The first line. Boom. Another secret to being so quick is that I'm messy and I just kind of keep going until I can't see. So if you're like, how can you see that? Truth is, I can't. All right, time for some shading. There we go.
I'm gonna test out my new little time lapse. I'm gonna test out the new GoPro Hero 7 Black time lapse on this to see how much smoother it is. Starting now. And that's the magic of editing. Off. We'll have to get a healed photo of it. I'll have to make you come back one day.
Yeah, exactly. Thanks, dude. You ready for that hug?
This is the moment I came for.
I'm gonna give it to you. You're gonna be the best hug ever. Oh! Yeah. Thanks, dude.
That's a good one. I'm not gonna lie, it's up there.
Yeah. And then you have your bandages, right?
Yeah,
they're my purse.
Okay, cool. Yeah, I say this every time, and it comes off silly, but if any questions, ask me. We'll do DM me, email me, whatever. Quick questions, DM is best. Long conversations, email is best. Because the DMs will get lost, but I can always reply, but. If it's like regarding an appointment, it may get lost in the DMs. You know what I mean?
Yeah, we'll definitely have to do this again.
Yeah, dude, thank you. Have fun.
Thank you.
Safe out there. Drive safe. Little cute half handshake.
Oh, my hand is awful. All
right, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you. You too.
Bye.
Take care. So, what are we doing on you today, man? What do you think about getting?
You know, I either want like that on my hand or that on my hand or like. Or that, but like I have this fucking thing going on right here, and I have nothing going on here. I didn't know if the, I didn't know if I wanted to put another one of these on
cover,
the other side.
Oh, to kind of match it, you're saying?
Yeah.
Let me see what you got.
I really got nothing going on.
Turn, face me, and let me see your other arm. You could pair it, yeah, but you could also, I think it'd be better to do, because you know, this one gets in the way of you capping off that sleeve. I wouldn't want to give you that same problem over here. So I'd say put something bigger over this. It'd be really cool to do something above this today.
Yeah.
Something bigger than that, just sitting right above it, facing forward too. Maybe not another animal head, but maybe like an eagle. You don't have an eagle in it yet, I don't see. You know, eagle would be kind of sick. Or something with a couple things happening would be really nice. Something that's round for the top of the arm. But we can figure out something together. Let's look through my stuff. We'll just float some ideas around and we'll just see what sticks, what you like the best, you know?
Yeah.
But I want to give you some options. Hands are rough, yeah. I would say don't do your hands yet. I'd wait till your arms are out of room and you're really solid at taking care of them. You're really ready. You know what it's like to be bugged in public for having them. You go get a job and they don't care about this and you're already covered. You might as well last frontier do that. But there's no reason to jump in too soon, you know what I mean? Like you said, digging in your pockets and shit, it's just a burden. So it's a burden that I don't want to give you just yet, you know? Just wait till the right time.
But like you have lots of space, right? Like you said, you have this spot you want to do, a pinup or something.
I like how this tattoo just, I don't know if I wanted to start adding like stuff on possibly. Like I kind of like,
right.
Like patches though. I wouldn't know if I wanted to get so full.
Right, I get that. I think if you get too full down here, it may look more empty here, whereas in sleeves are supposed to ascend down. Whereas if you fill up all this, it'll only really look cool with this shirt on. But the tank top on, it may be like, oh, I need that spot. So if you just kind of patch them around instead of focusing in one spot, do all the big shit, then do all the medium shit, then do all the small shit. But if you're not open to doing that, that's totally fine. I think that this spot's a really good idea before you do something big that's in the way. Because you still, like you said, like I said, you still got that spot, dude.
Yeah, that's a great spot.
It's a great spot. And so I think if you find something great to fill that spot, you know, do you have any roses in this arm yet? Do you have no roses yet? You have this spot, a rose, the stem would be perfect. You know, I mean, you can't go wrong with that. Mm-hmm. But there's also other options too, like rose is kind of like last option, like maybe there's something better. Because a rose would fit anywhere. In that spot, you have lots of room.
Mm-hmm. Oh, damn.
Yeah, that's yours. You look, I like that. I know, you got it. Let me get a picture of that one before I
paint it.
Let me get a picture of that one healed real quick, do you mind?
Yeah, let's do
it. You see it? Yeah, just go and hold that up, take that off, get naked. Yeah, it's just like right there. Oh, this looks cool. Cool. I'll get that one later too. It looks good.
No.
She's cool.
She is cool. That's my kind of girl, dude.
Oh, what up?
All naked and high heels.
You know, what if you did that one up here, like, let me see.
Really? Up there?
Up there, because this encroaches too far this way. That's narrow. That would fit there. And then also, you have a naked chick on you, but you can easily not have a naked chick on you. But if you want to have a naked chick on you, you have a naked chick on you.
So we're going to go over some of this.
No, it won't touch it at all. So, that's pretty good. Here, go ahead. And hold that up to your arm and go check it out in the mirror so you get an idea. Go and hold it up over there.
Huh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like even the way the leg is positioned, you know what I mean? It kind of goes around that tattoo. When I stenciled on, I can kind of like...
So how high would her head be?
Let me see. Put your arm on your side. Let me see the design. I would shrink it down just a little
perfect.
Bit.
Yeah, maybe up there.
I would shrink it like 5% just so it fits a little bit better and bring it like right here. So it would finish off that top. Okay. And you could even do like a couple clouds around here or something kind of to finish off the top.
I was wondering what was going to have to happen here.
No, that'll work, dude. It'd be a good one.
Ooh. Yeah, you are a master.
Pretty cool.
Let the master do his job.
All right, I would say go ahead and check out these clouds. I think
I'm already getting a boner note. I like it.
Go and check that out.
I'm good.
You believe me? You trust
me? Oh,
yeah. All right, well, I hope I live up to the hype. I hope you like what I make. I think that'll come out cool. Yeah. We're going to go ahead and start at the bottom, kind of work our way up. You ready?
Oh, yeah.
Something, huh? That's gonna give you an ability to think on it. The ones you remember are the ones that you really want, right? And then here's the new one, you haven't even look at it yet. What a babe, right?
Yeah, it should be.
It would also be cool if you're down. Would you like maybe like a little bit of a red glow kind of behind a couple peaks of it, you know? Just kind of like there's a backlight, like almost a neon behind it. Nothing crazy, but
yeah.
Just to give a little something extra, make your first tattoo that much more special.
Yeah.
This is your first one, right?
Yeah.
Sick, dude. It's pretty cool. I'm excited.
Oh, really?
Yeah, give me a hug. Yeah. And then slide into my back pocket.
Yeah.
Cool.
I got a wide thigh anyway.
Yeah, I want to make it fit, you know? Yeah. I won't make it oversized, but I just want it to fit that thigh nice.
Oh, yeah.
Reach it up from there. Yeah, that looks good. Looks good when you walk.
It'll feel sharp, it'll feel annoying. I'll be done in no time now.
No, I'm serious, dude. That was kind of scary.
Doesn't help if the machine's super loud, right?
Yeah.
A little bit of yellow. That's a wrap.
Dunzo?
Dunzo, there's your first tattoo.
Holy.
Not too bad, huh? And then now it's done, that's it. It just hurt for a little bit, you know?
Yeah.
Should just feel kind of like an annoying sunburn now for the next few days. Cool. Clean you up and explain the aftercare and all that jazz right now. Put some of this goopy stuff on you. Goopy stuff. Yeah, clean it in the shower, soap and water. Clean your tattoo is good. Don't worry, you won't wash it off, I promise. It's in there.
Yeah.
You felt it. It didn't go nowhere.
Okay. Thank you, brother.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, dude, thank you. Appreciate you letting me make it finally.
Yeah.
I know it's been on your brain for a while.
Yeah.
So that's the end of my work day. That's a little bit about how I work, the way I work, and why it works. To give you kind of a quick abbreviation of how it works, people tend to email me. Generally, they want to get my designs done my way. I'm very grateful to be able to do that. Someone will email me and say, hey, I saw a thing in the background of your video. How much is this jester dude? Like around $200. They come in, they're like, all right, yeah, cool. Generally, I book a 12 o'clock, a 3 o'clock, a 6 o'clock. Though that's a $200 tattoo, I'll finish that in less than an hour. I have plenty of time to bullshit, hang out, you to look through my line drawings, look at flash that you haven't seen in these videos that you can only see in real life. And while you're here, you're like, fuck, you know, I actually really wanna get this panther instead. No problem, not an issue. Generally, I wanna have something new every time you come. I want this to be a sample. You see a little bit, you come in, you see a lot more. There's a lot that doesn't get filmed, and today was an effort to show a little bit of that in the process, deciding factors, how these clients are picking their tattoos, why they're picking them, where we're sticking them, and why they're going there. You know, it's not as simple as grabbing off the wall and sticking it right there. Sometimes I'm adjusting things, I'm flipping things around, I'm like, you know, mixing elements of each thing, you know. Though things are off the wall, it does not mean that they're custom. Things are always unique to the wearer. They're always handmade and put on differently in different body parts. They are never the same. With that being said, I think today's video accomplished what I wanted it to. I'm not quite sure. I haven't edited it yet. But, I don't know. I wish I could have shared a little bit more, but I mean, I'm filming while working and tattooing. Doing my best, editing it myself, putting it out. There's a reason why this is the only channel like this on the internet. So if you're watching my videos and they helped you and maybe answer some questions and maybe it helps you learn how to get tattooed by me a little bit better and you want to book an appointment and now you're a little bit more aware of how this process really works behind the scenes, then that means this video worked and I'm stoked and I'm glad you found it. If you found this video well, as always, as everyone says, like, comment, subscribe, blah, blah, blah. Share with your friends, do all those things. They help me out a ton. I tend to make these videos, I put them out, and then they're out, and I don't care what happens to them afterwards. But I'd be very grateful if this could reach more people. After all, that's why I'm doing this anyways, right? Thank you. Bye-bye. I will see you in the next one. Be safe. Sleep tight. Don't let the bed bugs bite.